Diversify and Harper Audio present The Antiracist Kid, a book about identity, justice, and activism by Tiffany Jewell. Read by Channie Waits. A note before we begin. For a glossary and a list of books for you and adult readers, be sure to download the enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/pages/The Antiracist Kid. To the listener. Dear listener, thank you for choosing this book. I wrote this for you. I hope this book helps you to become the anti-racist kid you are. My name is Tiffany. I am a teacher, a mama, and an anti-racist adult. I grew up in a city called Syracuse, New York. I lived with my twin sister and my mom. I really love having a twin sister. I am a Black, biracial, cisgender woman and a person of the global majority. We will learn all about what all of these words mean later in this book. I have been a teacher for a long time, and I love working with people your age. You are amazing. You are curious. You want to know more about the world around you. You want to know why and how things happen. You are a really good problem solver, and you can help us adults find ways to make the world a much better place to live in for everyone. When I teach, I hear kids just like you say that they want to take action and make a difference, but sometimes the adults in their lives are not ready for them to do that. I want to tell you that you are never too young to advocate against racism and injustice. Being anti-racist is not just work for adults to do. Everyone can be anti-racist, especially you and your friends. In this book, I want to help you understand what anti-racism is. I will tell you a little bit about what I have learned about being an anti-racist person since I started doing this work. I will also answer questions about things you may want to know more about. This book is full of interesting information. We will look at three different big words and what each one means. Identity, justice, activism. You will also meet three people in this book who are kids like you. Their names are Ruby, Sean, and Danny. When I introduce them later, we will learn a little bit about who they are. They will also help me answer your questions about being an anti-racist kid. You do not have to listen to this book from beginning to end like many other books. You can start listening at the part that sounds most interesting to you. Parts of this book may make you feel excited or angry or sad. Parts of this book may make you feel confused. If there is anything in this book that you do not understand, ask the older people who helped you find this book. The words we use and the way we understand them can grow and change just like people. You will notice that some of the words I use in this book are ones you may already know and use every day. And some of the words may be new to you, ones that you have never heard of or used before. The words we use, the way we say things, and how we communicate, tell and share with other people have power. Words can include or exclude people. They can make us feel happy, like we have power. And they can make us feel sad like we do not have power. The words we use matter. They are important. The things we say and the thoughts we communicate with our faces and bodies have a big impact on the people around us. In this book, I try to use words that are inclusive because I believe we can all be anti-racist together. I believe that you will help to make this an anti-racist world. I am excited to work with you, anti-racist kid. In solidarity, Tiffany. Identity. identity, and you. What is identity? Identity means who you are. People use this word to talk about who they are as a person. Identity is everything that makes you, you, from what you look like, to what you think and believe, to what you like to do. Your identity is everything that makes you who you are. Everyone has an identity. No other person in the world has the exact same identity as you. Your identity is made up of many different parts. Some parts of your identity are easy to see, like the way you dress and how your natural hair looks. Some parts are not, like what you believe and how you think and feel. Together, all of the different parts of your identity make you who you are. What is my identity? Your identity comes from your family and your community. A community is a group of people living together in the same place. The place can be your neighborhood or your city or town. Community can also mean a group of people who share the same ideas and goals, who care about the same things. Your identity also comes from the people and things you see every day, like the people in your school and the shows you watch on television. Your identity comes from the way you understand who you are and what people see and believe about you. There are two different types of identity that people usually mean when they use the word: personal identity and social identity. What is personal identity? Your personal identity comes from you, your family, your community, the experiences you have, and the places around you. It includes your names, the foods you like, and the people you love. Your personal identity also includes your relationship with your family members and the people you care about. It is also what you are good at doing, what you want to get better at doing, and the things you call your favorites. Your personal identity is all about you, the parts of your identity that makes you different from other people. It's time to meet Ruby. She has some personal identities she would like to share with you. Ruby is 8 years old. Ruby lives with her mom and her ate, Gabriella. They live in an apartment, and her Lola lives in a house in the same neighborhood. Ruby likes to dance, and fall is her favorite season. Her favorite color is green, and she loves ice cream. At school, Ruby likes Reader's Workshop because she likes to read a lot. Ruby has a pet turtle that she found when she was playing a game of hide and seek with her friends. The turtle's name is Raphael. The turtle lives in a big tank in a corner of the bedroom she shares with her sister. Together, all of these things make Ruby's personal identity. Some of Ruby's friends have similar identities, and some have different ones. You will get to meet her friends soon. What is social identity? Your social identity comes from the parts of you that relate to other people in your community and around the world. Your social identities fit into different categories that have been named, created, and defined by society. Some social identity categories are race, ethnicity, gender, citizenship, and class. Society is a group of people living together in a community. It can also mean people in the larger world community. In many societies, people work together to make sure that there is peace, safety, and justice. Not all societies have the same goal for all of the people in the community. Race is what other people see when they look at your skin color and skin tone, hair texture, and other parts of the way we look. Ethnicity is the parts of your identity that come from the common place or share the cultural traditions of all of the people in your family who were born before you. Gender is the way many people in society believe that a person should behave based on whether they have male or female body parts. A lot of people think there are just two genders, female and male, but there are many, many more. Citizenship is having membership to a country by law. A citizen is a person who is allowed by law to be a member of a country. Class is a group of people who have a similar amount of money and resources. Someone who is in an upper class has a lot of money, and they are rich and have power. Someone who is in a lower class does not have a lot of money and may not own property or have much power. Race and ethnicity. What is race? Race is a part of your identity that does not usually change. It comes from the skin, hair, and other parts of the way we look that we were born with. Race will be a part of us throughout our whole lives. When people talk about race, they are talking about what other people see when they look at your skin color and skin tone, hair texture, and other parts of the way you look. People who look similar in these ways are part of the same group, even if they are not part of the same family. That group is called a race. Everyone has a racial identity. What is a racial identity? Your racial identity comes from the race or races that you are a part of. In the United States, the bigger groups for race that the government often uses are Black, American Indian, Alaska Native, Asian, Native Hawaiian, Pacific Islander, White, Hispanic, and Latino, Latina, Latinx, or Latine. These are the groups people usually think of when talking about race. Some people may have racial identities that do not belong to any of these big groups. Some people may belong to more than one group. Everyone has a racial identity. Let's meet Ruby's friend, Sean. His racial identity is Black. Ruby's racial identity is biracial. Biracial means that her parents or ancestors have different racial identities. Ruby's mom is Asian American. Ruby's dad is Black. Why do different people have different skin colors? Everyone has skin. It protects everything in your body, your bones, your blood, your muscles, and your organs. Your skin has melanin. Melanin is the natural coloring of your skin. It helps to protect your skin from the sun. Some people have more melanin than others. People whose ancestors are from places where the sunshine is more intense have darker skin. People whose ancestors are from places where there is less sunshine have lighter skin. Your ancestors are your family members who were born before you, including your grandparents, their grandparents, and so on. Some people know who their ancestors are. Some people do not know who their ancestors are. The words you may use to describe skin color are not very clear. There are very few people who have skin that is as white as paper or as black as ink. Everyone's skin has color, and that color comes in lots of different shades and tones. Some of the words you can use to describe skin color are ebony, golden brown, beige, tan, freckled light pink, and dark brown. There are so many different ways to describe the color of your skin. What words can you use to describe your skin color? When people talk about being black or brown or white, they are not just talking about skin color. They are also talking about the community they have with all the people in the world who have skin like theirs and the things they have in common. For a long time in the United States, indigenous, Black and African, Asian, and Latine people have been called minorities. Minority means less than half or a few. The number of indigenous, Black, Asian, and Latine people in the world is a really big one. There are more Black and brown people in the world than there are white people. Person of the global majority is a term people use instead of using minority. It is a more positive way to talk about Black and brown people. It also helps everyone to remember that the group of people of the global majority around the world is a big one. Where did race come from? The idea of race has not always been around. Race is a social construction. This is a big way to say that race was created by people in society. A group of people who share the same racial identity are a racial group. The different racial groups we talk about today were made up by people in Europe hundreds of years ago. It all started during a time when people from the continent of Europe called.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.